project, and this is Val. And this one is off-season basics, build and bend. And this particular sequence is a sun salute sequence that will help you prepare for some nice deep opening in the areas of your body that you're going to want to recover and rebuild at this time of year. All right, so let's get right to it. Standing at the top of your mat, feet are hip-width apart. Take some weight into your heels to make sure that your core is a part of everything you do. On an inhale, sweep your arms up to the side, lift the heart. Exhale, forward fold, keeping the spine as straight as you can, as long as you can. Inhale, extend, and then exhale, step it back to down dog. Place the hands, step it back, pushing downward forward with your hands. Inhale, take your, which leg?
Right.
Right one up, and sweep it forward, warrior two. Raise yourself up to a warrior two, okay? So let's take the arms overhead, palms together, and rotate your chest as far forward as you can. Take an inhale here. On your exhale, twist towards the front leg. Yeah, so inhale to raise it up. The exhale is this twisting warrior. So if you find that this long of a stance causes your heel to come up in the back or you're just unstable, you're gonna hold after three or four. Then if you find that your heel's coming up, you're gonna wanna take a slightly shorter stance or sometimes a slightly wider stance can solve that. So she's pushing down from her palm now and she's letting everything turn up. If you can visualize a bit of a back bend in your upper back and yeah, pull the skull back a little bit, that's really gonna help. And then we also wanna feel like we are lengthening back through this right hip, okay? And that's it. Let's place the hands down, let's take it back to down dog. Okay, inhale, plank. Exhale to lower it down. Elbows point back and let the hips set down last. Inhale, coming to a cobra. So yeah, so she's letting her shoulders widen and move back and drop down. On the exhale, go to a down dog. Next exhale, yeah. Okay. Left leg is gonna go up. Inhale that and sweep away forward to warrior two. Drop your back heel. Raise it on up. Okay, so this is your warrior two. Now, palms together overhead and rotate forward with your ribs. Big inhale here, exhale into the twist. So think of this first one as a test run. So move through that three or four times. And if you find you need to adjust your foundation, do it, okay? Because by grounding your back heel, you are setting your hips so that they will receive the treatment of this part of your sequence. If your heel comes up, then you're cheating your hips out of what they could possibly be getting. Yeah, so she's pushing her palm down because that will help this other shoulder come up and back. There's a sensation of coming back through the entire upper body so that the base of the skull is even coming back into a little bit of a back bend in her upper back. Her left hip is pressing back. Yep, sideways is getting longer. And then we're gonna place the hands down. Exhale, back to down dog. Okay, on an inhale, step or feel like hopping, hop to the front of the mat. Extend, and then exhale to fold. Okay, inhale all the way up. Take your arms wide, palms come together overhead. Exhale to sit in chair pose. Inhale, crown of the head forward and the hips back. Exhale, we're gonna twist it to this side.
Oh my goodness, that's so over.
Yeah, then next inhale, raise all the way up. Palms go together. We're gonna arc it that way. Yeah, take a breath when you've arced there. Let your left hip drift left. Inhale to raise yourself up. Back to the chair pose, sitting. Yeah, so she's got a nice extension of her spine. Crown of head forward, hips back. Twist it. So this, think of having an axis straight forward in the room. It might require you to push your opposite hip back, opposite side to what you're facing. On an inhale, you'll come all the way up. Palms will come together again. You'll arc it in the direction you just faced. Let the right hip or opposite hip shift to get more arc. Inhale to come up, and then exhale, hands come to heart center. Okay, recall and intention. And release the hands. Let's do this again, and this time with a slightly different warrior. Inhale to come up. Exhale into forward fold. Okay. Inhale to extension. Exhale, step it back, down dog. Okay, inhale, we're gonna take up our right leg. Exhale, we're gonna sweep it forward, warrior two. We're doing something I call glute burner. Raise it up to warrior two. Now turn your front palm up. Come into what's normally called a side angle, but instead of setting your elbow on your leg, it's just outside your knee. Now reach forward with your left arm, because I'm mean, and actively press your right knee out into your right elbow. And you're gonna start to feel the gluteus medius really firing. So breathe through this about 3, maybe 4 breaths. Then we get to give that glute medius a break and flip into a side plank on the left side. So she'll place her left hand and then her foot will go about halfway down the mat. Toes are facing in the direction she's facing. Reach forward with your top arm. Push forward in your left hand. See if you can get the hips to come up even a little bit higher if she pushes forward into it. Okay, cool. About 3 breaths there. And then back to the down dog. And then inhale to a plank. Exhale, go ahead and lower all the way down. Inhale, coming to a nice high cobra. Exhale into down dog. Okay, left leg's gonna go up. Inhale, take it forward, warrior two. Inhale to raise up to warrior two. Exhale into that glute burner side angle. Yeah. So she's pressing her left knee out. And she can feel the pressure into her left elbow. About 3 breaths here, letting the hip really fire, letting it warm up. Okay, we'll flip it. The right hand goes to the floor, and then we flip onto side plank, and the foot faces the direction you're facing. Really push in the left foot. Yeah, if you can push in the left foot and push forward into right hand, you'll get the hips up like Val is able to do here. Or, you know, maybe not like Val, but you'll get them up higher than without doing those actions. On your next exhale, we'll go back to down dog. Okay, on inhale, step or hop to the front of the mat, extension, and then exhale to fold. Okay, inhale to come all the way up, and then exhale to sit in chair again. Inhale, crown of the head forward, hips back, exhale, twist it to your right. Okay, so if you want to, here you can get deeper in this. So Val can bend her knees more, take her left elbow across, take her left arm to the floor. Right arm can go to the sky. There's more of a tendency to diagonal off the mat when you get here, so you might have to push your left hip back even more and try to take the whole upper body more towards the left. Next inhale, you can come all the way up, palms together. Okay, let's do interlaced fingers, palms up for a little bit more space, and then arc it to the right. And then let your left hip shift to the left. There's a lot of pushing down through your left foot so that you can get the grounding that allows the expansion. Then raise yourself up. Go back to the chair, hands to heart center. And then spine forward in the room like an axis. Twist it to the left around that axis. In order to get your right hand down on the floor, you do have to bend your knees more on this, okay? So some people are like, I can't do it. Well, it could just be that you just need to bend your knees a little more. Also, placing a block underneath your right hand can be helpful for this. So she's turning up. She's trying to push her right hip back. Oh, yeah, she got it. Next inhale, she'll raise up and interlace the fingers. Palms up, arc it left. Hip is shifting to the right, strong grounding through the bottom of your right foot. On an inhale, raise on up, and then hands come to heart center. Recall that intention. And then moving through one more sense loop. Inhale, our hands alongside hips first. Yeah, grounding. Inhale to come up. Exhale, and forward fold. Okay, inhale extension. And exhale back to down dog. Okay. Inhale, we'll go right leg up. And exhale, sweep it forward. Warrior two again. Yep, we keep doing the warrior twos because they're very hip centric. And then we're going to go into a bound side angle. Okay, so now instead of elbow going outside the knee, it goes inside the knee. We drop it way down the shin. Now the trick here is, in order to get the other hand, you have to rotate. So if I go here and I try to reach back, it won't. Okay, she's there, she's holding, she's taking it back to me. Instead, I have to rotate like this. This is what I gotta do, and then I can maybe go and grab that. If not, you drop a strap from the top hand down. Okay, so next up, we are going to release out of this. Raise yourself up. Straighten up both legs, toes facing the direction that you're facing. We've got a block out here, and we're just going to put palms together and come into a straddle with the pinky side of your hands on the block. You want to know what's there. All right, so now she's allowing her weight to really shift forward, which is how you can get the muscles in the back of the leg to release. So you notice in the front of the sun salute, I'll say weight in the heels. That's because you need those things firing as you are eccentrically moving into a forward fold. But then here what we want to do, we want very little activity of those muscles. So that means like we don't even really want that eccentric contraction very much. So if you let the weight comes forward onto your feet, you're gonna remedy that. Okay, so she's gonna walk her hands to the front of the mat, step it back to down dog. So that's a nice way to get some hamstrings. Inhale to come up to plank without being too intense. Exhale, lower all the way down. Okay, inhale, we'll come to that high cobra, and then exhale to down dog. You can also feel free to do up dogs here with the chaturangas if you prefer. Right leg is gonna go, left is gonna go up. You take it forward to your warrior two. Okay, so here you'll be able to see what she does with her arm a little bit better. So she's gonna lower her left elbow inside of her knee. She can take it as far down as she can. So she's trying to pivot back to make that hold. If she couldn't make that hold, she could drop a strap from this hand and make that connection to get the same effect. So she's gonna hold there, push in your left heel for a little bit more activation of the back side of the leg. Okay, and then maybe two or three more breaths because I feel like we were there forever. I know we were there forever while I told you a lot and demonstrated my forearm. All right, so now we'll raise up. Toes are gonna face in the direction you're facing in a wide straddle, and then you'll come out into the straddle with hands resting on the block. Okay, so when the hands are resting on the block, you want the block at a height that will allow your head to drop through your upper arms. So you're gonna be placing a height specific for you. And so for Val, she can have this block really low. That might not be the case for you. Let the weight come forward onto your feet and the back body is releasing. So a nice long hold here. So it is a little easier on the hamstring to do a wider forward fold than it is to do a narrower one. So it's a great thing to work with right now. And then take the hands to the front and of your mat and step it back to down dog. All right, so we can inhale, step or hop to the front of the mat, extension first, exhale to fold, inhale to come all the way up. Now we're gonna do a wide leg chair. So take your feet about shoulder width apart and sit down into your chair. And then do about the same thing that we did before, crown of the head forward, hips back like an axis, spin to your right. And then you can take left elbow inside of left knee, or you could try a bind here, which is gonna look like that. That's fun. Okay, it's the same thing that you did when you were trying to bind in the other pose, the side angle. So now we're going to go ahead and come all the way up, okay, and the left leg is going to go into tree pose, and then we're going to arc it to the left. Okay, so left leg goes somewhere on the inner right leg, and then let the body arc. Left, your right hip shifts right, or the foot can go on the floor, and then her hips are going to shift and her body's going to arc.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
My balance is up.
No comment. Okay, so raise it on up, and then we do it again, other side, so feet are going to be hip width again, shoulder width again. We're going to sit down in the chair, we're going to twist it, and so you can just elbow in here if you like, but to get deeper, you can use the same technique as what we did with the other bind and roll yourself up. So it's a bound twisting chair. So breathe, try to push in your left heel a little bit, and then we'll come all the way up. And now that right leg is your tree leg, okay? And then we arc it to the right.
Yeah.
So breathe. And we tree. Some days are better tree days than others. Okay, raise it back up. Place your foot, hands to heart center, call your attention. Okay, so that's the sun salute preparation that we'll do. Next up, we will be hitting the wall to do some deep releases.